The joint forces have managed to capture alive at least 17 ADF terrorists, recovered 20 SMGs, rifles, 3 PK machine guns, and vital documents, according to Major Mugisa.
At the moment, there are 51. The two were killed yesterday, but one in Kikingi. In Kikingi, we had a contact with the ADF rebels. They fell in our ambush, and we killed two.
He also revealed that a total of 5 UPDF officers have, since the operation started, lost their lives in what he termed as operational mistakes.
Most of them have died just because of individual errors. Individual errors where you manhandle a weapon, like an RPG, you're not supposed to handle it carelessly. Others have just drifted from, as they're climbing the hills, and a bullet just goes off, then it hits him.
Major Mugisa says that there is a general reduction on ADF attack, raids and abductions on civilians, especially in areas where the joint forces are operating. Mugisa says that other social places such as schools, churches, mosques and health centers have reopened in the formerly ADF-dominated areas of Eastern DRC.
That region is very peaceful. Socio-economic activities are now going on well unfettered. Schools have opened. Churches are now operating, hospitals are giving services to the people.
Major Mugisa attributes the success of the Operation Shujaa to the maximum cooperation and coordination between the joint forces as well as civilians.
Civilians have started digging roads that were now in bushy. For instance, from Kikingi to Mwenda, they are the civilians who are clearing the roads so that they enable us to move a little bit faster.
He says the vast and difficult terrain in which the joint forces are operating has given the ADF terrorists a significant survival advantage.
Our soldiers in the beginning used to suffer from skin diseases, diarrhea, cough, these other diseases like bilharzia. Just because they were not used to the environment.
Major Mugisa also says that the poor road infrastructure is also a challenge, since infantry fighting vehicles often break down.
The bad roads that impede our logistical supplies. Most cases we normally use a helicopter, but it also has cost implication.
Currently, the UPDF is also engaged in civil-military activities such as medical outreach programs, key leader engagements, road rehabilitation projects, and provision of water points. Story by Roger Sandy for the news.